In this video, we will be discussing about distance-time graph. This is question from exercise 2B of D2, 7th edition. We will be also studying how to interpret distance-time graph and how to read where we are at rest and where the speed is more, where the speed is less. So let's discuss the question. The graph shows Hyrule's journey when he visited a friend in town C. This is town C. And this graph shows the journey when Harold started from his home at 10 hours and continued till he reached at point A. This point A is the cafeteria where he stayed up till this time, and then he continued his journey again from B to C. So, during the journey, he stopped for breakfast at a cafeteria, after which he continued to drive to town C. Now, the distance-time graph is a graph where we have distance on y-axis and time is on x-axis. Now, how to interpret this graph? Wherever we have a horizontal line, that shows no distance is covered. So, when no distance is covered, we are at rest. Whereas inclined lines shows steady speed. This straight line shows a steady speed. This straight section shows a steady speed. This straight line from O to A we have a steady speed. From B to C we have a steady speed. Though we have less speed over here, we have more speed over here. We will be finding the gradient. How to find the speed? You will find the gradient of this section. You will get the speed. Because gradient is y over x, change in y divided by change in x. So here we have distance on y and time on x. So y over x means distance over time. So distance over time means speed. So the question is, at what time did he leave home? That is simple. He left home at this point, and here the time is 10 hours. So the answer is 10 hours. He left at 10 hours. Part B is, how far did he travel before he reached the cafeteria? The word is how far. How far means they want distance. So when he reached the cafeteria, and how do we know he is at cafeteria? Because he is at rest. So when he is at rest, so he is at cafeteria. After point A, there is no increase in the distance. So he is at cafeteria when he is at point A, and at point A you can find the distance. You can see the distance from y-axis. Distance is 50 kilometers. So he has covered 50 kilometers from his home till he reached cafeteria. So the answer is 50. Find the gradient of OA. As we know, gradient is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, change in y divided by change in x. Now, for that we need 2 points. We have 2 points. 1 point is at A, 1 point is at the origin. Here we have got coordinates. The value of x is 11 hours and the value of y is 50 kilometers. Here the x is 10 hours, whereas the value on y is 0. 0 kilometers. So the coordinates are 10 hours on x and 0 kilometers on y. Use y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. y2 minus y1, 50 minus 0 divided by x2 minus x1, 11 minus 10. That is 1 hour. So the answer is 50 km divided by 1 hour. Now what does this show? This shows speed, 50 km per hour. Now the gradient shows the speed. Now what is the gradient from A to B? The second part is find gradient of AB. This is a horizontal line. There is no change in y. When there is no change in y, we have zero gradient. Because gradient is change in y divided by change in x. So there is no change in y. So gradient is zero. If gradient is zero, that means the speed is zero. We are at rest. This section shows that he is at rest. He is at cafeteria. What is the gradient of BC? Third one. Take 2 points on BC. The coordinates of C are 1200 hours on x, 80 kilometers on y. and at B we have 1130 hours on X and 50 kilometers on Y. This is X2, Y2, this is X1, Y1. So gradient is Y2 minus Y1, 80 minus 50 divided by X2 minus X1, 12 minus 11, 30. 80 minus 50 will give you 30. 12 hours minus 11, 30 hours give you half hour, that is 30 minutes. So your solution will be 30 kilometer per 30 minute. This is not the final answer. We have to find answer in kilometer per hours. 30 kilometer over 30 minute, cancel 30 with 30. Answer will be 1 kilometer per minute. In order to convert minutes into hours, we need to divide by 60 because 1 hour has 60 minutes. Convert minutes into hours, divide by 60. Divide this minute by 60, your answer will be 60 kilometer per hour. After dividing minute by 60, now this is converted into hours, while this 60 will move in the numerator, your answer will be 60 kilometer per hour. So this is the solution of this question from exercise 2B, D to 7th edition, as well as we have studied about the interpretation of distance time graph. Thank you so much.